Welcome back, friends. Today, we're going to destroy this perfectly good coffee table.
We're Jenny and Davis.
We fly through hurricanes for research and build furniture for fun.
A while ago, we came up with a business plan to sell quality furniture, which brings people together.
Follow along as we build our business empire.
Empire?
Yes, Jenny. Big goals.
Okay, we're starting an empire. Maybe one day it'll span beyond the garage.
So this is our coffee table. You may remember it from such hits as this video right here. We really, really liked it. It worked out well for us, but now we need to cannibalize its ash top. It's not because it warped. It's not because it exploded, because clearly it's still here. We literally just need this ash top to use for our new coffee table prototype. Up a little bit. We're starting another woodworking business here in the Houston area. And our last woodworking business was fully custom. Like, we would build it to order based on the exact specifications that every individual customer wanted. And that worked for us, but we don't really want to do that model anymore. But we also don't want to be on the other side of the spectrum where we're mass producing and playing the inventory game. Where we want to live is somewhere here in the middle where we're following a very similar model to a restaurant. There's a menu of different items that you can select, so there's a little bit of customization, but you also have a plan for every single item that's on that menu. So for the customer, they'll still have a list of multiple options they can choose from, but from us, we'll have something that's easily repeatable because there are a limited number of selections on that menu. So that'll allow us to scale the business and make it large enough where we can hire employees, but it doesn't require the level of like very detailed craftsmanship that you need in like 100% fully custom work. So does that make sense at all? Our first item on the menu is gonna be this coffee table. So we're gonna build our prototype out of our old coffee table. So we sat down to design this super awesome prototype coffee table, and that's when things started to get a little hairy. So we had a ton of questions, like, what style do we want to go with? Do we want farmhouse? Farmhouse modern? Modern? Boho? There are just so many options, and we had to pick one, but we weren't quite sure what the right one would be. And then, on top of all that, we heard every single voice of friends, family members, YouTube comments, Instagram messages, all giving us different ideas of what we should do with this coffee table. You should make it modern. You should make it DIY. You should make it farmhouse. You should make it white, black, gray, ash, walnut, oak. 8 million things that we've been suggested, all spinning around in our heads, and we had to make a decision on which one we were gonna go with for our prototype. So basically, we told all the voices in our head to shut up. Which, that sounds really creepy, I know, like voices in our head. We're not crazy, I promise. We're not like actually crazy, just a little crazy.
You don't have to be crazy to do this, but it sincerely helps.
So anyways, we told all those voices in our head to shut up, and basically we just had to sit down and outline what we knew.
So here's what we knew. Number one, we're in Houston. We're in the South. So following the advice from our sales and marketing programs, link in the description, farmhouse is the design style that we need to go with if we want to be successful to a large swath of the population. And we also knew that we had to make this table profitable at the $1,000 price point. That's roughly where our price is going to land. So we had to make sure that working backwards from there, that we were going to be able to make a profit. So we designed this new coffee table with those things in mind, and here's what we came up with.
So we finished up creating our first design, and we really started to like it. Keeping in mind that we wanted it to be like more farmhouse focused, we kept it pretty simple and in line with that. It had a really nice thick ash top, so it seemed really bulky and heavy and, you know, high quality, which it is. It's something that's bulky. It's not gonna break very easily. And then you got into like the kind of wide, chunkier, square legs on each side. And then coming out of those, you had like that little angled X design that, like, you know what I'm talking about, like that farmhouse X that you see on almost every piece of farmhouse furniture. I know that sounds kind of like tacky, like, oh, why are you making it just like every other farmhouse piece of furniture? But that's what people are familiar with. That's the farmhouse they know, that's the farmhouse they've seen and that they're comfortable with. So give the people what they want, right? And then we've got these really nice curved feet on the bottom on both sides. Basically, the whole design just looks really nice and classic and sleek. We have a question for you. When was a time that you got advice from somebody and you knew that you just couldn't use it? Let us know in the comments down below.
So then we started building, and that's where it gets fun. We started changing, tweaking things on the fly in the plan just to make it more repeatable, try to make the parts a little bit more identical. I guess what I'm trying to say is if I can mill one board to a certain size and then get four different parts out of it, that's gonna be way more beneficial for us than making a completely unique, optimal sized piece every single time. This is just a completely different building style than trying to do 100% custom work, because when you do custom work, you build it once, and as long as it's really nice, you never have to do it again. But when you're trying to build at scale, you gotta think about inventory of lumber. How easy is this for an employee to do? Is this repeatable? Is there a faster way to do this? Like, just all these different questions that we never had to ask ourselves. All I'm saying is that Lincoln Logs, they got it nailed down. If we could, like, we're just trying to build every piece of furniture to be Lincoln Logable, if that makes sense.
You're looking at.
Try to figure out how far in this is. I gotta go back to the plane. This is also really frustrating too, because when we're building, we have a thousand different ideas popping up out of nowhere. Like, oh, what if we did it this way? Or what if we made it this angle instead of this curve? What if we made it a 3-inch round instead of a 1.5-inch round? Like, there's so many questions and so many like what ifs. It's really hard to tune them out. And that's kind of what we talk about in our podcast this week. Quick plug for the podcast. It's just knowing what voices to listen to and which ones to not listen to. But bottom line, we're really excited with how this is coming together. Next week, we're going to finish the coffee table, so be sure to subscribe so you see that unveiling and us take pictures with it and everything. So yeah, hit that like button if you like the video, and yeah, catch you on the next one.